expected, many call the loudest in the NFL. We are inside GEHA Field at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. Straight ahead, a rematch from Super Bowl 57, as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the defending Super Bowl champions, the Kansas City Chiefs. Well, we thought this could get interesting. Here's interesting, an onside kick to start this thing. Hands team able to cover it up. They tried to give this home crowd something to cheer about early, but it failed. I don't know, maybe you try that on the road to get some momentum. What about here at home?
Would agree with you totally on that. I think at home, you don't ever want to put your fans in a position where they're questioning what you're doing. And right now, they have to be in the stand saying, why would we even do that? We're already behind you. You don't need us anymore. And this one, boy, an unsuccessful attempt, that could really change the momentum of this game in a hurry.
On first and 10, it's Swift. Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play, second down.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big time play?
Right back to Swift again on second down. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
First down as they get him to the ground at the 37. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Once again, it's Swift. Down the numbers. There he goes. Touchdown, Philadelphia. DeAndre Swift, 37 yards. And the Eagles are on the board first here on the road in Kansas City. Elliott Good with a PAT. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Hardman will elect not to bring this out, and the football will be on the 25-yard line. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Hey, 15.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. This one complete. It's Rashee Rice. And they're able to get this one across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
On first down, Mahomes. That ball caught. It's Rice. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. That one goes for 30 yards. Now here's Mahomes. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. That'll be caught by Rice. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line. that's not just his first, not his second, already his third completion here on the opening drive. And I think it's safe to say that getting him the ball in this game, one of their top priorities.
And a top priority for the defense has got to be finding ways to cover him. And I don't think you can have one basic coverage to get it done. You have to throw a number of coverages at him, make him think as he's running downfield, and hope you can create a little bit of havoc.
Mahomes again here on 2nd and 10. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And the Eagles are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. I have to be thrilled with that first drive that got him the touchdown. Now they'll be looking to make it a two-score advantage here on the road.
And you know, they spent all week in practice, in meetings, talking about taking an early advantage. Being the road team, going up a score, that takes the crowd out of the game and puts some doubt in the minds of their opponents.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a 2nd and 10. Hurts being chased out left. Hurts dangerous when he runs that football. He's got a first.
That's the first time he's called his own number, but he's got to be overjoyed with the result. He wasn't just going to settle for a modest gain. To me, he was determined to come through with a big message to a defense that slept on him in the pocket.
And he'll manage to pick up about 4 at 2nd down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
Off the play fake. Here's Hurts. Flushed out right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. Throw left side is complete on the diving effort. A big play there for Philly. 41 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for 1st and 10. From the gun, here's Swift. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. And they'll come up 2nd and 7. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard. 2 minutes on the clock, 2nd quarter, 7-0 ball game. 7th play of the drive, forthcoming on 3rd and 8. Hurts sets up to throw it. Jalen Hurts on target to Dallas Goedert. And the Eagles have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. Elliott good on the extra point, and that'll make the score 14-0. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And the Chiefs are going to make the recovery. A 2nd quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Oh, everything falling apart now. Another one intercepted. Picked off by James Bradbury. And the Eagles are going to have it here as they'll start at their own 24-yard line. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, 2 first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? On second down, Swift. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 62 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
Yeah, this is going to be an Eagles first down as he's able to get this up past the 40. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. But first down, Hurts. That is caught. It's the tight end Goddard. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Here's Hurts to throw. Touchdown, Eagles! Dallas Goedert as the first half is winding down. And the Eagles would extend their lead here just before halftime. Elliott now to add the extra point. And oh, he clanks it off the right upright. And it's no good. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Attack, attack. Now Mahomes. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Now he's loose down the left sideline, inside the 10, and all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Isaiah Pacheco in the final seconds of the first half. And the Chiefs are on the board here in the final seconds of the first half. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that cuts this lead down to 13. So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. It'll be the Chiefs football to begin quarter number three, and they trail here as we are back underway now on EA Sports. And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
And the offense moving quickly to the line. Mahomes to throw on second down. Man open, that's Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 22-yard line. To throw, it's Mahomes. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. So following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13. Throwing now is Mahomes. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Mahomes going to throw. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. They'll go for it. It's Mahomes. He's got a man complete. And that is caught. Touchdown, Kansas City. Rashee Rice, 31 yards. And the Chiefs' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead will shrink to 6. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. But Charles, they still have the lead despite their defense giving up a touchdown on the previous possession. And even though they have that lead, it feels like a back-and-forth ball game where to try to get momentum back, maybe they need at least 3 here on this drive.
I think you're right about that, Brandon, because your game plan doesn't change. But I do believe your urgency does because of the last score that went against your team. So what you want to do now is have your own drive and try to make sure that momentum stays in your camp.
Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Throwing is Hurts. And that is incomplete.
And that's a real good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the 3-and-out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line.
Attack, attack! 43! 43!
Throwing on first down is Mahomes. Buying time to his left. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a 3rd and 4. On 3rd down, it's Pacheco. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
First and goal at the 9-yard line.
Mahomes now to throw.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Mahomes hitting his favorite target, Travis Kelce, on the touchdown pass. And the Chiefs have even the ball game with a chance to take the lead here in the final minute of this third quarter. Extra point by Butker is on target.
And that will put them on top here in the third.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
Charles, we'll see how this offense responds. Remember the last time they were out, they went for it on fourth down, did not get it, and that led to a touchdown on the other side. So they need a response here.
They certainly do, and I just have a question for you. You think that was a gut feel, or was that analytics that came into play there deciding to go for it on fourth down?
That felt like gut to me. What about you?
Yeah, absolutely, because the way it backfired, where they are in the game, all those things, that didn't feel like an analytics call. That certainly felt like, hey, I think we can get this right now. And unfortunately, it didn't work out for them.
So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. The Eagles on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and four. On third down, here comes Swift. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
He's brought down at the 39-yard line. An 8-yard pickup. And an Eagle first down.
He'll get that complete to Albert O. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. On the option to give to Swift here.
Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
On the option to give to Swift here. And he can only get this to the 42-yard line. And that is not near enough. Call it a gain of 5. Fourth down now.
Well, they got off the field on third down. An excellent job, an excellent defensive series. We always talk about adjustments and usually only at halftime. But the best teams adjust series to series. And on that series, they adjusted so well that they got the job done in fine style.
They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And the Chiefs will have the football back in excellent field position.
They couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day. One score game. First and 10 here.
Short throw held in by Kelce. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The catch and run good for 24 yards.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up.
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies.
Fletcher Cox there for the tackle. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. And this defense right now, backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in. And all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is, first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Less than 2 minutes to play. Down to the wire we go in a one-point game. Now Mahomes going to shift him around. They'll try for the first with Pacheco. And here he'll get it down to the 7.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line, I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Well, looks like they'll move things around here. They'll run here with Pacheco. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to 3 on a gain of 3.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation. And taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. Pacheco will get down close to the goal line, but not in, as he'll be marked down at the 1. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. Here's Pacheco, and he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it. Butker on for the PAT. And with that, the lead is up to 8. After the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. They'll come up 1st and 10 here. He's back to throw. Pass complete, Goddard. And he's going to pick up a 1st down here as that clock continues to run. Now the Eagles will use the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. 63. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. And the Chiefs have just about sewn up this football game. What a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead, and now that's what's happened.
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, won't you?
Hey, but I'm a bad writer.
I don't know exactly what happened, because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too comfortable, too relaxed, and a couple of things go wrong, and it's hard to get back that good feeling.
Well, somebody lit a fire under that offense during the break, Charles. Remember, they trailed at intermission, they come out, they have the big 2nd half, and that lifts them to the victory.
And Brandon, trailing at halftime, we always talk about teams making adjustments. You know what the best adjustments usually are? It's just executing better. Because the game plan you put in place at the beginning of the week often still holds. You don't have to make wholesale changes. You just have to do a little bit better, a little cleaner. And they did that in the 2nd half, and that led them to victory.
Well, that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more,